Darwin begins Chapter 2 of The Origin of Species by noting that naturalists have only a vague sense of what a species really is, and the term variety is also difficult to pin down with a definition. This vagueness is important since one of Darwin's goals in this chapter is to call into question the precise delineation of species. He next considers individual variations we observe within species in nature. Under the heading Doubtful Species, he discusses in-between forms, forms that might be argued to belong to more than a single species. Darwin claims that these intermediate forms are both more stable and more common than is generally supposed. This fact supports his theory of the transmutation of species. If we do not observe clear-cut and distinct species of animals and plants, but rather a range of forms, many of them intermediate, then the idea that one species can, over time, produce another is more plausible. With examples of conflicting verdicts from well-qualified naturalists, Darwin makes the case that the boundaries between species are not clear and obvious. About halfway through the chapter, on page 51, Darwin reaches his key insight. Clearly, no line of demarcation has, as yet, been drawn between species and subspecies. These differences blend into each other in an insensible series, he writes. This being the case, the differences between individuals may show us the possible beginnings of a new form. Darwin writes, "Here, I look at individual differences as of high importance for us, as being the first small step towards such slight varieties, which may, if strong enough and lasting enough, become new species." In light of these facts, Darwin argues that the terms species and variety do not name essentially differing groups, but are arbitrary designations for groups of individuals that resemble each other. The final third of Chapter 2 is devoted to an argument from what Darwin calls botanical arithmetic. We'll discuss that in a separate video. Thanks for watching today. Goodbye.